Hello, and thank you for joining us. Welcome to today's webinar. I'm Sridevi, and I'm part of the Learning and Content Management team. Now let's take a look at our agenda today. Today's session is designed to provide you with all necessary information for effectively submitting a LaTeX file to Editorial Manager. We are delighted to announce that this is our third webinar dedicated to LaTeX, incorporating feedback from our authors from the previous two sessions. During this session, we will cover the following topics: introduction to LaTeX, templates we support, and we are going to see a demo on how to upload the completed template to Editorial Manager, and we will be using our test site for demo. The final item on our agenda today is special because we are going to be addressing frequently asked questions where we have selected the most common scenarios, and our experts will be providing live answers for us in the call today. Our introduction to LaTeX, in which we have LaTeX. LaTeX is a software for typesetting documents for high quality typesetting. This is most often used for medium to large technical or scientific document. LaTeX features includes typesetting journal articles, technical reports, books, and slide presentation. Typesetting of complex mathematical formula, automatic generation of bibliographies and indexes, and control over large documents which contain sectioning, cross-reference, tables, and figures. The templates that we support include CTAN packages, ELS article, which was first developed and released in 2007 under LaTeX Project Public License, BibTeX style files. This is for 10 different typeset models. This was also released in 2007. ELS CAS templates. This is for the journal articles and complex article service CAS and other journal specific LaTeX template. We would first like to take you through the LaTeX submissions, the LaTeX instructions, available on Elsevier.com for authors under policies and guidelines. I'm now going to share my screen to show you the LaTeX page for authors. So to download the entire package, you can click on the download the journal article template package, which will now be downloaded straight to you. Earlier, this was downloaded after many clicks. However, this has recently been changed to help our authors. For detailed instruction on how to complete this template, we have ELS article documentation, and this gives you step-by-step instructions on how to go ahead and complete the template. Should you have any specific questions in this, you can contact elsarticle@stmdocs.in, and they will support any queries related to ELS article documentation. Coming back to our LaTeX page, we also have single and double column class files available for complex articles. And to obtain the file, you can click on the download option available here. Following recommendation from our previous webinar, we created a video on downloading and completing the LaTeX template. We understood that this was a challenge, and what we thought of doing is we created a detailed video which includes the steps on how to download the template from here and how to upload it or complete it, basically. We'll now see how to complete the template and the text file to Editorial Manager. But prior to that, I wanted to tell you that the instructions that you see in this page is also available in the Guide for Authors section. In the Guide for Authors under LaTeX, you have our template. And apart from the template, we have also included the instructions and also the support link here. And if you are a beginner, you can refer to our Beginner's Guide to Writing a Manuscript in LaTeX. So as an author, you can log into Editorial Manager, and while you click on Submit Your Manuscript, you would be selecting the appropriate file type. And now I am in the Attach File step, the second step, where I wanted to share a couple of details here. So for initial submission, most of the journal allows you to submit the manuscript as PDF by selecting Manuscript as the item type, which is here. However, for the revised submission, right, so for the revised manuscript as such, in the attached file stage, You can add the text file as an attachment to your submission by selecting Revised Manuscript in this category. Make sure you upload any necessary support files, including .bsc, pip, or style files, under the manuscript or the revised manuscript item types based on whether it's an original or a revised manuscript that you're trying to submit. Figures and graphics must be tagged under the figure item type. Now moving on to the top of the screen. So here you can attach a file from your computer by dragging and dropping it, or you can also go ahead and click on Browse to browse your computer's file list. There are a few instructions that I wanted to share today, which I'm sure you will find it useful. You can attach a file from your computer, as I mentioned here, but I would like to mention that do not refer to a site where your files are stored in your text files. The path will not be recognized by the system, which will result in an error. Also, ensure that while Overleaf might recognize the command, Editorial Manager cannot process LaTeX submissions in folders with a specific file path. So it cannot find files referenced from a folder. To include the file's unique archive identifier, if you have them stored on your archive system. Also, please ensure that you select appropriate file type in this item drop-down. So ensure that any files that you upload has the appropriate file type selected. The submission does not contain any subfolders as LaTeX files or the subfolders because this will not be processed by the editorial manager. Keep all your submission files, such as figures, tables, style, and bibliography files in the same folder. Clicking on Proceed will allow you to go ahead and add additional information if needed. And after you complete, as you normally go ahead and build PDF for approval, you would be building the PDF here. And once your submission PDF is viewed, you can go ahead and submit it. Now, in terms of viewing the PDF, you will be clicking on View Submission, and you can also approve it should you find if these are all okay and good to go. But let's talk about a scenario where there are chances that the PDF may result in an error at times. We would have seen a lot of such scenarios, and you contact us for help, right? So what are we going to do now? We're going to pick top five scenarios today, and I'm going to be sharing those scenarios. And we have our expert Hema from Elsevier Support, who will be answering these questions live to us. Now, let me go back to my presentation. Hi, Hema.
Hi, Sri.
Right. So, Hema, we have a couple of scenarios. And the first scenario that I wanted to ask you on behalf of the authors was, why does my PDF have numerous question marks instead of citations? So, I've also included a screenshot here for you. Over to you, Hema.
Thank you, Sri. Hello, everyone. As mentioned, we will now discuss some of the top queries, and I will explain you how we can resolve them by following simple instructions. This saves your time and effort in creating the PDF in Editorial Manager. To answer your question, I will elaborate on the reasons for these missing citations and provide guidance on how to resolve them quickly. We see most of the time, BIP and BSD files are categorized under the item type LaTeX source file or supplementary material. At times, the BIP file is not uploaded for the submission process. So these scenarios can lead to the appearance of question marks in the final document because the system could not access them when you classify these files in a different item type. So to ensure a smooth PDF building process, it is necessary to upload reference files such as BIP, BBL, and BSD under the manuscript or revised manuscript item type. Once you upload these files in the right category, you will see the citations generated in the expected format. Hope this information helps you for your future submissions.
Thank you so much, Hema. Coming to the next scenario, so my question was, why do I see a LaTeX error log in my built PDF document?
That's a great question. Thank you for asking. Just as we receive logs in local or online compilers, the submission system will also generate logs if any corrections are needed in your manuscript. The system is designed to compile files successfully only when there are no errors. If you encounter such logs, it indicates that compilation process in the editorial manager was not successful. So we can easily identify these types of errors or what kind of error stops you from building the PDF successfully. Just by using Control F key in the final build PDF, we can use some common keywords like error, warning. So in this instance, using the search key, I was able to find a fatal error. This particular error arises when supporting style or class files is absent. If an author employs multiple text files but provides only the main text file, similar errors will be encountered. It is advisable to upload all the text files and supporting files, especially style, class, used for your paper preparation, and we need to classify them under manuscript during original submission and revised manuscript if it is a revised submission. So we need to classify them accordingly in these item type, and by following this step, you can avoid these kind of errors.
So the scenario three I had was I have uploaded all necessary files, but I'm still encountering a LaTeX issue in the final document. Can you explain us the reason behind this?
Sure. It is a common and significant concern that we frequently come across. We know how challenging it could be to have uploaded all the required files and still facing an error in the final document. When dealing with multiple files, it is possible to overlook uploading some of them. So in this scenario, we could see that some file is missing. From the file name and format, we can confirm that one of the figures is not found. As explained earlier, by utilizing the search keywords to identify the error, we can find the missing files and upload them in the attached files section to ensure successful PDF compilation.
So we have two more scenarios for the day, and the scenario four is, well, I encountered a LaTeX error log into generated PDF. I attempted to determine the root cause, and then I discovered that some figures were not appearing, and I went ahead and uploaded them. So despite uploading the figure files, my issue still persists. Could you explain why are the figure files still missing?
There are various reasons for receiving errors in the final PDF. In this image, you will see the file path along with the file name is mentioned in the error line. So this shows that figure file path is used in the include graphics command. As we explained in the previous section, subfolder structure is not supported in the editorial manager system. Though the required files are uploaded, it is important to note that in the submission system, all these files are uploaded to the same working directory. Therefore, the need for file path within include graphics or input commands are not required. Hence, to successfully build the PDF, we need to remove these file paths specified in include graphics as well as input command if it is mentioned. Once you remove all these file paths from the text file, the revised file needs to be uploaded in the submission system and rebuild the PDF. So with this, you will now able to generate the final document correctly.
So on to the last scenario today. And this is, I managed to create an error-free PDF successfully using my local compiler. However, I'm puzzled as to why am I encountering errors during the submission process. And this is my error message that I received.
It is not uncommon to encounter differences in the compilation process, especially when you are transitioning the files from your local compiler to a submission platform. Here, I could see the error received is invalid UTF error. This error mainly occurs because of the presence of special characters, which the system could not process due to various reasons. These characters might be present in your tech file or bib file. We can resolve this LaTeX issue by just loading the package, use package UTF-8 input ink in the main tech file. This helps in processing most of the special characters used in your manuscript. By this, you can resolve the UTF-related errors popping in your build PDF. Now, I would like to add an important instruction which will help you to avoid confusions in categorizing the source files. So please note that the LaTeX source files item type is used only to provide the source files additionally whenever you are submitting the manuscript in PDF format. If the journal specifies to provide editable formats, then tech and main supporting files BIB, BBL, BST, style and class, including nomenclatures if you are using them, should be tagged under manuscript or revised manuscript. And the figures need to be tagged under the item type figures. So this helps you to avoid any primary issues which we have seen now and during the submission process.
Thank you so much, Hema. So we have our dedicated FAQ page that has been created for the LaTeX error code. So if you discover any other error apart from the top five scenarios, or even those top five scenarios are included here. Now, we had created this page exclusively to go ahead and identify and fix error for the LaTeX error codes, right? So we have actually gone ahead and identified the top 10 scenarios, where what we have done is we have included the details, the cause for it, and also the solution. I'm sure this is going to be really helpful for you, where you can come to this page, look for that error, and go ahead and try out the solution to make it an error-free PDF. Right. But coming back to my editorial manager screen now. So let us assume that you had a look at the FAQ. You did try, you know, your best for the solution, but you still need help. You are not able to proceed. You can go ahead and click on this question mark logo in your editorial manager screen. And this logo will be available in all the screens that you navigate in editorial manager. Please click on chat with Elsevier support, and you will have our chat agent responding to you for the query. Thank you for listening to the content of today's session. We hope you found it useful. So that brings us to the end of the webinar today. Thank you for listening to us.